Yo, long time no see, guys. It's 720p Gamers here. This is quite a mad little video. Today I'll be showing you how to install Linux on one of the most annoying, inconvenient PS4s ever released on 7.02. What I'll do is give me 1 second because I'll just read out what model number it is. So the model number is a CUH1216A, and with this one it's one of the hardest ones to install Linux on. It's not the easiest one. So what I'll do is, first of all, easy way of getting this to work, go to settings, and then what you want to do here is you want to do sound and screen. First thing you want to do is you want to just make sure that your output settings is 1080p. Because if you're on a PS4 Pro, don't follow this guy. Go to Modern Warfare's Modded Warfare's video and follow his PS4 Pro video, because he'll show you how to do it properly on there. But with mine, this will just show you like how to get it installed on this one certain model, because this one, I spent 8.5 hours just doing this. I ended up having to message him to ask him how to do it, how he did it, because he has exactly the same console as me. So you just want to make sure your RGB range is exactly the same as normal, automatic. You just want to make sure your HDR is off, always. Make sure you can't adjust it, which is good. And then what you want to do here is you literally want to go back. You want to go all the way down to system, and you want to literally scroll down to here. Turn off HDMI device link, because I forgot to turn that off. That caused me a problem. HDCP, turn it off immediately. So that's all you need to do on the PS4. And then what you want to do is switch over to your PC, which in my case, I'll just do that right now. So here we go, so we're on the PC. What you want to do is just make sure you have this program installed. What I'll do is I will pop this in the description. This is the main one Modern Warfare used it as well, because it's one of the best. You want to literally just click, it's really simple, just click flash from file, and then what you want to do is just grab the Geno disk image, press open, or Gen 2, sorry, select the target. In my case, I'm just using the bog standard Western Digital 320GB hard drive. I am using an SSD on my main boot whenever I boot into it, but this is just for video, just to show how it works. You do is select that, and then what you want to do is just click flash. So you click flash, you press I'm sure, and then it should take a couple of minutes just to flash that off. Right, we're back again. So if it says validating, it's up to you if you want to validate it. I don't really care, because at the end of the day, there's no real point. I know it's installed, it's all okay. What you want to do is just get rid of it in general. So just close down the program, and then what you want to do is, because you can't eject the drive, like most people recommend, oh please eject your drive. Yeah, if you can, do it. If you can't, just do what I do, just unplug it, it's fine. Then you should hear the noise, then just re-plug it back in. And what will happen is, nothing should really happen. It might make the sound, but nothing will show up. You just want to right click your Windows button, do disk management. If you're not on Windows 10, just type in on the search bar disk management and it will pop up as the first result. You literally want to scroll all the way down until you find the hard drive that you're trying to install this on. So it should be laid out like this. So you should have most of the drive unallocated, 10 gigs allocated just for the image file in general, and then you should just have a healthy partition. If this is showing up on your PC as actually being a thing, which in my case is, luckily, and most people it won't be. So what you want to do is you literally want to just literally hover over it, press change drive letter or drive paths, press add, and then you literally just press assign following drive letter, press OK, and then what will happen is then it should show up as this as mounted image. So because you're on the dodgy, the super duper unlucky PS4 that's an absolute pain to install Linux on, you want to just completely scrap the BZ image it comes with and the Infirmus FS file it comes with, because they're rubbish, they don't work. No matter how much you try, they might work for your screen, maybe at a push, but 90% of the time it just kernel panics. I haven't had one yet that actually works on my monitor, and my monitor's just a bog standard Asus with a 1ms refresh time on it, and it's a 65Hz screen. So, well, it was a 60Hz screen. So there's nothing fancy-dancy about my screen at all. So what I'm doing is literally, most people just clear it out like so. I'll delete it like this, I'll just be a sensible human being. I'll do that, drag over these two, I'll link these two in the description as a full zip file so you can just download both of them in one hit, because they actually are, if you follow Modern Warfare's video of how to install it, you'll notice that he recommends that you have to cipher through and pick through which ones work for what model you have, but this one's just specific to this model, so I'll put them on my model in the description, but this is the one that it mostly works with. It might work with other models, highly doubt it, but you can give it a shot. I know that I can't run ITA, ITA Linux, well, the PSX ITA Linux, I just can't run it in general because it just kernel panics or can't find the image, which is very strange. No matter what I do, it just doesn't work, and I'm not wasting loads and loads of time in my life to figure it out. This Linux distro, it's okay, it's not the best, don't get me wrong. Yeah, they've gotten rid of quite a lot of permissions, but that's where it's Arch Linux. It's a little bit more painful to get used to, but it's okay, it's not too bad. So what you want to do after it's all like this, this is cool, you don't actually need the PC anymore, so just unplug the drive, stick it into any random USB port on your PS4, which is absolutely fine. Just make sure you do have a USB hub, because otherwise this is going to be very painful, because otherwise then you have to keep switching out, and obviously you cannot unplug the drive when you're running Linux, it just doesn't work like that. So let me just switch over to my PS4 quickly. Let me just switch my screen over, because I'm not on my PS4, but you guys can see it. So what you want to do, because I'm on 7.02, which is a bit of a funky firmware to be on in general, literally just delete all your frequently used pages, go into your browser history, clear that completely out, just do the standard, clear out your settings, just normal stuff. And then what you want to do, just use this host is the best for Linux that I found so far. Linux 3GB VRAM does not work on this model yet. I'm waiting for an update. I've tried 3 million times, I just get a black screen. Even through just having just the Elgato plugged in, I get just a black screen. So we won't worry about that one. Just want to go for 1GB for the time being, just to get it running. Just then you have like a general understanding how it works. This exploit does take a little while. So what I'll do is I'll just keep recording whilst it's trying, which is always a fun one. But it shouldn't take too long. But yeah, just please note, you just need to have a big enough hard drive for this, or just use a box standard USB 16. Anywhere between, I'd recommend anywhere between a 32GB USB or a 64GB USB. But I try to avoid using USBs just because the download speed on them is absolutely awful and the rewrite speed on them is rubbish, no matter, even if you go for a 3.01. So even if you do use a 3.0 USB, the read and write speed aren't as quick as a hard drive. So just try and get like a little cheap little portable hard drive case. And if you have like an old laptop lying around with a hard drive inside of it that you don't use anymore, just get a screwdriver, unscrew it, take the laptop hard drive out and just stick it into one of these cheap Amazon enclosures. That's a 3.0 enclosure. They tend to work a lot better than what you would think they would work. But any 3.0 enclosure will do. This should work. It's just loading up the Linux payload. It will go black. It will say no signal for a couple of minutes. If it does this where it just hangs for a while, just leave it to it, because it will do it eventually. Hopefully this program doesn't cut off the audio, which I know sometimes it does, by the looks of it, it didn't, so that's good. But yeah, it will say no signal. It'll do this for a little while. Your TV might shut off, it might show this for you. Hopefully it would. But hopefully that should be it working correctly. Hopefully. It should just say mounting. I might have the wrong... Oh no, maybe not. I do have the right one. So it should pop up like that. That just means you're booting into Linux, which is a good thing. And then what you want to do is just wait for until you see the mouse on the key, the little cursor on the screen to plug in your mouse and keyboard. Because if you do it too early, what will happen is it will cause you a little bit of a problem. It might kernel panic. So right now, this is when I would say plug in your keyboard and mouse. So I'm plugging in mine. Just need to find my keyboard because I moved it somewhere because I didn't need it. Oh, here we go. There you go, Linux should be loading now. This will take a little bit longer, just because I'm running a hard drive. On my SSD, this is nearly instant, so I would recommend an SSD, but obviously I know not everybody has £4 million to spare at the end of the day. So whatever suits you at the end of the day, it's just loading up Linux, so it'll take a little while. The only issue is with this, with these images, the only issue that I find with this model in general is the fact that someone hasn't updated the kernel, so we have Wi-Fi and Bluetooth drivers yet. But I know if you plug in a PS4 controller, it connects snap of the fingers, same with anything you connect to it, including a wired cable, it will connect straight to the internet with no problems. So like, for instance, mine's connected to the internet absolutely fine with no issues. So we have a wired connection currently, so that's absolutely fine. But if you want this to look a bit like Windows, all you want to do is literally just unlock the widget, then you just want to click edit panel, and then this should pop up. What you want to do is literally just press remove panel. No need to panic. All you got to do is just right click your desktop and then literally just press add panel, and then I think it's a default panel off the top of my head. There you go, that's the one you want. Then just click edit panel again, and then what you want to just do is screen edge and then just scroll it down like that. And then what you want to do is just press a little red X over here, and that should just lay it out a bit like Windows then. And then all you do is just press here, and then you have like, this is a bit slower than my SSD, I'm not used to it yet. It literally should just load up like this, just like how Windows would. And then in your applications, you have like alternatives to all sorts of things. You have RetroArch, Retro Gaming, you have a PS4 Remote Play Client, which is good. You've got a Wii U GameCube emulator, which apparently can play Wii U games. This is just an open gaming platform, which I'm pretty sure is actually Steam, I'm pretty sure, from what I've heard. Oh no, this is Steam, so if you press this, this will just open up bog standard Steam. And that's just Sega Saturn, and that's just all the other just normal stuff that you tend to find. I think that's an N64 emulator by the looks of it. Yeah, but you have quite a few features on this, actually, to be fair. It's not too bad. Only issue is sudo doesn't work as an installation, and you can only execute files, and you have to compile them yourself. Here's the only issue with this distribution. So if you want like Discord or anything sort of PC related, you're going to struggle quite a lot. I haven't even managed to get Minecraft installed, which is basic as basic. It just won't install no matter what I've tried. I've tried the Arch Linux distro installation files, they don't work. I've tried everything, it just doesn't work. It's just this distribution's all locked out and made a bit annoying, so you can't pirate games and stuff like that, I'm pretty sure. But I'm pretty sure via this method, I'm pretty sure you can install any form of Linux anyway, but soon to find out that. But if I do find another way of installing like Lubuntu, like a box standard Linux with custom kernels on it, then that will be amazing, because that means then we can use any program we want when we want, without too many headaches. But Wine is pre-installed, which is good, but you can only run pre-installed programs, so like stuff that doesn't require installations, same as like Mac. If you own a Mac, then you know how Wine works. Exactly the same issues on Linux, so it's always fun. Steam, a large quantity of games are compatible, but there are some Windows wrappers pre-installed into this Linux, so you can actually run most games without too much of an issue. There might be some performance problems, because obviously you're on this model of PS4, so you will be getting performance problems, unfortunately, because you can't run the 3GB the 3 gig Linux VRAM dedicator yet, which is a bit of a problem, but I think they'll update that very shortly. But that payload host is one of the best out there at the moment for just running Hen in general, or running any form of payload such as Linux and etc. etc. But if for instance, if you need to change the password for this Linux distro, you can. The username's just PS4, password's PS4, you can change that quite easily just in terminal. Just look it up. Modern Warfare did a massive video of how to do that part of it. And he showed everything. HDMI audio over HDMI works on this PS4, luckily. But if you go to the other link I will put inside the description, this will give you some other kernels. Apparently, one of the kernels does work for this PS4 without using my kernels, well, the kernels that I'm using. And that gives you access to Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, but the problem is it's very picky on what TV or screen you're using. So it's very, very limited of what screen and what TV it can actually use. So hopefully that's enough information for you guys, and I'll leave it at that. So enjoy the rest of your day. I'm out. Cheers, boys. Enjoy.